countdown is on to the spooky spectacular. That is Blackburn Rovers against Fleetwood Town. We'll talk about the match and more on today's show. That's right, folks, back once again with another match preview, this time building up to the Halloween spectacular. That is Blackburn Rovers against Fleetwood Town. And a match that's not been seen on the football calendar ever before. In fact, tell a lie, it was seen once in the Checker Trade Cup. We'll talk more about that in just a second. Let's dig a little bit deeper and take a look at Fleetwood, currently managed by German Uwe Rosler, who previously managed last-time opponents, Wigan Athletic, for a short stint. The game obviously taking place October 31st, 2017, a.k.a. Halloween. Last season, Fleetwood finished fourth, a respectable fourth, in League One, and currently top goal scorer Devante Cole with 8 goals. Like I said, the previous match between Blackburn Rovers and Fleetwood Town should be really classified as Blackburn under 23 against Fleetwood Town. We lost that 1-0, and that was all the way back August 30th, 2016. Let's take a look at how I think Fleetwood will line up come Halloween. In goal, Cairns, Easthamme, Bolger, Cargill, Coyle, Dempsey, O'Neill, Bell, Grant, and there's that big fella, Devante Cole, and McAlhany in there. I'm not too familiar with the Fleetwood lineup, but I do have a bit of recollection of Devante Cole. He's a bit of a prolific goal scorer. He's doing the business all right for Fleetwood right now. Let's take a look at the form books going into the game. Fleetwood, currently only 2 wins out of the last 5. And that includes last time out when they beat Oxford at their own gaff 2-0. Before that, they lost to Shrewsbury 21st of October 1-0. Fleetwood also drew with Scunthorpe at their place Tuesday 17th of October. Stretching all the way back to the 14th of October, 2-2 draw against Rochdale. They go all the way back to 7th of October, you'll see a 2-1 victory for Fleetwood at Bottom Club Plymouth. How about the statistics there? Let's take a look at some of the hot topics amongst Fleetwood. As I said, Cole tops scoring charts with 8. Homulia's in there with 7 goals. Ashley Hunter's got 3. Grant has got 2. It's 2 prolific hot topics up front. Homulia will probably make the bench. Again, I'm probably butchering that name. Meanwhile, it's the discipline. Bolger's got 5 yellows. Easthamme has got Easthamme's got 3. Dempsey's got 3. Ponder's got 2. 4 red cards, at least 4 red cards anyway, for Fleetwood. Burns, Dempsey, O'Neill and Rogers, all with a red card. As for Blackburn Rovers, this is how I feel their lineup. Much changes are needed due to injury to Chapman, suspension to Bennett and also Samuel. But this is how I think Rovers will line up. Ryer and goal, Nyimbi, Downing, Mulgrew, Williams, Conway, Whittingham, Smallwood. Glad we're not going to give him a chance now, see if he can rectify that miss the other day. Graham and Dak. Let's take a look at the form books for Rovers going into this game. Obviously, last time out, a precious point against Wigan, down to 10 men towards the end, even down to 9. If you haven't looked at my review, please check that bad boy out. Before that, 21st of October, Blackburn Rovers 3-0, convincing 3-0 victory over Portsmouth. Turn the clock back a little bit further to Tuesday, the 17th of October, a 1-1 draw at home to Plymouth. Still trying to get over that one. That was a shocking performance from the Rovers. In fact, it was a bit of a bad run for Rovers, as before that, we lost 1-0 away to Oldham. And all the way back to the 3rd of October, that sloppy, who gives a hoot, 1-0 home defeat in the Checker Trade Cup. Let's take a look at the statistics, or at least the goal scorers. Dominic Samuel still tops the pile, 5 goals. Mulgrew with 3, Dak with 3, and Thompson with 3 into the discipline. It's now getting a little bit more colourful in there. Eddie Bennett's got 5 yellows, Evans got 4, Small's got 4, Bradley Dak has got 3, and we have now got 2 names in the illustrious red card column, Elliot Bennett and Dominic Samuel. So let's turn social media, still a little fresh after the Wigan game, so the Fleetwood banter not really cooking up just yet. I'm sure it'll get a little bit more intense as the countdown approaches. But there are some little tidbits out there, so take a little sneak peek. Blackburn Rovers posted this on their Twitter. Next up for Rovers is Fleetwood at Ewood Park on Tuesday, and a chance to go 5th. Some replies to the tweet. Robert Whittle says, any chance we'll get a decent ref at EFL? That's a little bit of a dig at Saturday's performance from the referee there. Tom Berry said, need to win our 2 games in hand to look a lot healthier. I agree. Jacqueline Watts also said, really must win this one and many, many more. Come on, you Blues. At C.T. Wilkie said, well, to change a winning team into a drawing team, it will no doubt be a changed into a losing team. So a little bit of a downer there from Wilkie. Moving forward, Frank Andrews says on the Blackburn Rovers supporters Facebook page, 3 points today would be brilliant, but to be fair, I would settle for a draw and then beat Fleetwood on Tuesday. That was actually taken before the Wigan game. Like I said, it is a little bit slim pickings for the banter at the moment. Meanwhile, Andy Partington, also Blackburn supporters page, hoping we beat Fleetwood Town on Tuesday, but not very confident how the mighty have fallen, LOL. Meanwhile, Tom Allen, also on the same page, good point away from home, gonna beat Fleetwood at home. So again, referencing the Wigan game, but also looking ahead to Fleetwood. Matthew Grimshaw, the one Jack Walker side, said, good point, now let's beat Fleetwood. Now, over the years, a number of players have played for both Fleetwood Town and Blackburn Rovers. Here are just a few. Josh Morris was on the books at Blackburn Rovers, didn't really get much of a chance, but he also played for Fleetwood Town. Meanwhile, ex-skipper Barry Ferguson played in the Blue and White Halves, and he also played for Fleetwood Town. Meanwhile, under-23's coach, head coach, Damian Johnson, yep, Blue and White Halves, and he also donned whatever strip the Fleetwood Town wear during his illustrious playing career. Well, it's not really what I think that's going to happen, it's what Cass the Cat thinks that will happen. Let's take a look at what the Cat thinks will happen between Blackburn Rovers and Fleetwood Town and in this Halloween spectacular. Make sure you hit the subscribe button and keep your bang up to date with all things Blackburn Rovers. I am on Twitter, Facebook, SoundCloud and iTunes if you want to check me out on the go. This, for me, I believe is a must win for Rovers. Yes, Fleetwood Town are a top 10 side, and they are doing the business again this season. They're going to be a threat. They have got the firepower up front. That's one thing that does continue to baffle me, is that we cannot, for the life of me, find the back of the net. We have quality, aka quality players in Danny Graham, Dominic Samuel, and even Marcus Antonsen to a point, but we can't find the back of the net. Could this be the day that Joe Nuttall gets a name on the starting? Well, he might get a name on his name on the starting team sheet, but at least the bench. Let's give him I wasn't too sure if he actually made the bench for the Wigan game. But either way, this could be an opportunity for Joe Nuttall to come in, step up with the plate, and show us what we're talking about, especially for the home faithful. That would be immense. Meanwhile, yes, it's sad times that we do have to do without Harry Chapman. He is a game changer. Until we have another game changer on the bench, not too sure. Clutching at straws right now by looking at Ben Gladwin coming in. Perhaps another opportunity for another youngster to step up. Joe Rankin Costello, he's a decent talent. He could do with some game time, or at least get his face on the bench. Anyway, that's all I've got for you. I'm hoping for 3 points. Then we kick on. I think we have an FA Cup game coming on the weekend. So there'll be no preview for that one, just a match review. So until next time, thumbs up, subscribe, ciao for now.
Thanks again for watching. Please like, share, and most importantly, hit that subscribe button. It'll keep you bang up to date with all things Blackburn Rovers. But if you want to check out something completely different, head over to my other YouTube channel. You do that by pressing the button right there. If you want to check me out on Twitter, Facebook, details are in the description below. So until next time, thumbs up, subscribe, ciao for now.